Man's never been in marquee when it's shut down, eh? Trust me, daddy.
Yeah. Hey, man's never been in. When it's shut down, that's not me and it's shut down. Ring, ring, pussy, it's shut down. Hey. Fashion week and it's shut down. Went to the show sitting in the front row in a black tracksuit and it's shut down. Touch the road and it's shut down. Boy, better know when it's shut down. Yeah, take time if a man want to try me. No time. Usain Bolt, when I run up on stage, I pick up the mic.
Yeah. This edition of Carl on the Couch, Let's Talk Property, comes all the way from sunny Barbados. My home, my second home. Now, people, what I want to talk to you about today is a lot of people have written in and said, Carl, do I deal with property abroad? Okay? What are my feelings around property abroad? Now, here's what I honestly feel, okay? I don't personally get involved in property abroad, okay, as an investment point of view, unless you've got these three or four things working for you, okay? These are the most important things. People, if you're thinking about getting involved in property abroad, I know people who have lost hundreds of thousands of pounds when investing abroad, okay? Now, here's the four things, or three or four things, that you need to make sure, okay, that if investing abroad, these things are on in your favor and you've sorted them, okay? Number one, you really, really need to love the country, guys. You need to love the country that you are going to invest in. Because the worst case scenario, okay, if you can't rent out that property or something bad goes wrong, this could be a home for you in the future. Maybe your retirement, maybe your holiday home. You could give it to people to go over there and chill out and whatever, okay? You need to love the country you're investing in. Don't get involved in all of these, like, you know, invest in Lithuania or invest in Russia or some crazy places. You know, I know Bulgaria was kind of like a hot place, like, you know, 7, 8 years ago or 10 years ago, okay? No one knew where Bulgaria was. All right, so forget that. Don't get sucked into this kind of get rich quick thinking, all right? You invest in the places that you love. So if you've got a home country, if you've got somewhere that you'd really love to retire to later on, somewhere that's close to your heart, then yes, that gives you a tick in the box. You can think about investing there. Right, second thing, you've got to trust in the developers abroad. It's so difficult, okay, to control building when it's in another country. Control the development, control the builders, control what's going on. You know, many people get ripped off in this area, okay? They spend a load of money. They send over money to the builder. The builder turns around and says, oh, you know, we never received the money. Or, you know, we received the money, but, oh, you know, we had to buy a load of stuff to go in the ground, when really they're building their own house, okay? I've seen this happen, people. You know, you send money, next thing the builder's got a lovely house and your house isn't even out the ground. All right, you must know the developer. You've got to check them out. You've got to fly over to the country. You've got to go and see other properties that the developer has built. Preferably you want to go with a big developer. Do not think about, you know, look, this is big money here. Don't think about, oh, you know, I'll get some trades people in and stuff like that and I'll try and cut corners. You can't cut corners when you're developing or buying in a second, in a foreign country, in a country that is not your place where you live, okay? So, you gotta love the country, all right? You got to know and trust the developer. Make sure you've seen what they've done. Get recommendations. Go and see other projects that they've done. Make sure they're a big, reputable company. Okay? Third thing, your finance is so important. How are you going to pay for this? Are you going to get a mortgage from a bank in the country that you're buying in? Are you going to get a mortgage from home? Or are you going to fund it cash? Because the thing is, the stage payments, if you're buying a building from a new build, you're going to have to pay in stage payments. Normally, that could come in the region of 5 stage payments. Again, this is negotiable. You can negotiate this with the developer, okay? But normally, you have to pay something up front, all right? And then normally 20% across So for instance, 20% when the hole's dug, 20% when the foundations go in, 20% when the first level goes in, and so on until you pay the final part on exchange of contracts, all right? So if you think about it, if you're buying a new build development, it's normally gonna take anywhere between 12 to 18 months. So you've got 12 to 18 months, and every, let's say, 3 months, you're gonna have to be spending 20% of the total price of what you're paying for your home, all right? So make sure you've got your finances in place, because otherwise, in the contract, it could be that if there's a significant stall, your price is either gonna go up, or they could claw it back and sell it to someone else. So all that money that you spent up to that point will be gone, all right? So finances, make sure, please, you've got them in place, you know how you're paying for your second home abroad. Thirdly, or fourthly, very important, the law, okay? You need to understand the property law in the country that you're buying in. You need to make sure you've got a very good solicitor in the country you're buying in, because it may and probably will be different to where you reside, where you're living at right now. So for us, it's in the UK, all right? So the property law in Barbados will be slightly different, and I need to make sure I've got myself a good property lawyer in Barbados, okay? So guys, the reason why I'm telling you this is because I'm just in the middle of purchasing some property in Barbados. We're doing a deal with a developer over here. You know Elite Investments, man, we're getting worldwide, baby, worldwide, okay? It's a fantastic development down in Westmoreland Hill, if you know Barbados. And these are the key things that I know I need to make sure I've got in place when I'm buying this sort of land. So guys, if you're thinking about buying property abroad, investing abroad, you need to make sure, one, you love the country you're investing in. Two, you trust the developer. You've seen the developer, they're big, they're reputable, okay? You've gone out and you've seen other deals. Three, your law, make sure you've got good solicitors, good lawyers in the country that you're buying in. And number four, make sure your finances are in place. Guys, I hope you've liked this version of Carl on the Couch, Let's Talk Property. I'm out. Like me, subscribe me, check me out, pass me on to your friends. It's Carl on the Couch, Let's Talk Property. Ring, ring, pussy, it's shut down. Fashion week and it's shut down. Went to the show, sitting in the